Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm pretty excited because I get to share with you one of my favorite utilities that I've been using forever on my computer, which is now available on my mobile device. Oh yes, we are going to take a look today at TextExpander on Dotto Tech. TextExpander is one of those tools which has become indispensable to me. We did a video in the past on TextExpander, which you can check out should you choose to. But my ardor for TextExpander has not waned at all since I created that video. It is one of my go-to tools. TextExpander in a nutshell. It is a text utility. It's a keyboard shortcut tool. You type in a short series of keystrokes and it expands into something more elaborate. It could be as simple as a URL or it could be as elaborate as a letter, a sales letter, or a full document. It saves you keystrokes every time you use it. And it saves them through something called snippets, which we save here. Now let me just show you quickly. Here's TextExpander on my computer. And let me just open TextExpander. This is a Mac only tool, I should point out. However, there are similar products to this in the Windows world, which you can check out. I don't think anything integrates quite as tightly as what we're going to look at on the smartphone, but there are ways to kind of work around to get to this point in the Windows world. At any rate, here it is. Here is TextExpander, and you can see I've got a whole series of different little snippets that I use over and over again. So I use these for everything from shortcuts to put in my subscription URL when I create these videos, all the way through to much longer automatic replies sort of thing, or semi-automatic replies to people that are contacting me to ask for information on one topic or another. If I can can it, if I can take the same content and use it multiple times, I create what's called a snippet with it. Now, these snippets would be very useful to have on our smartphone as well. And we can indeed have the snippets available on our smartphone if we install TextExpander Touch, at least on our iPhone, which I have set up here. Now, the snippets are stored, the brilliance here is the snippets are stored in Dropbox. It's like a preferences file in Dropbox. So as long as my smartphone can access my snippets on Dropbox, then I can use the same snippets that I've created, the same shortcuts that I've created for my computer. Now this also works from computer to computer. So on my desktop computer that I'm working on here, my notebook computer, and on my smartphone, I can access the same snippets on each of those devices. Pretty cool, eh? Now, on the smartphone, it's not quite as simple. On the desktop computer, this is installed as a system resource. You install it and every application that you run has access to these to the snippets. On your smartphone, things aren't quite as cut and dry because on the smartphone, what we have to do is we actually have to install a custom keyboard. Now, to install a custom keyboard, you go into your settings, you go into the general settings there, you'll find keyboards. And we can install custom keyboards for a variety of different topics. What I'm telling you here is this TextExpander won't work on the Apple keyboard or on your Emoji keyboard or on the Ginger keyboard that I have installed here. You have to use the TextExpander keyboard in whatever application you're using on your smartphone in order for it to work. Does that make sense? When you install it, just one quick tip. When you install it, you actually have to make sure you go into the keyboard settings and make sure that you've allowed full access in order for it to work. It took me a little while to figure that out the first time that I set it up. Now, once it's installed, we can see it right here on my smartphone. We don't use that app very often. We go into the app itself to set some of the general settings, but actually using TextExpander on our smartphone, we do when we are in our normal text entry screen. So if I just open Snap Entry, which is a nice, simple text tool that allows me to quickly create notes for EverNote, I've got my keyboard here. And you see that I've got the Smile keyboard, which is the TextExpander keyboard. If you want to change keyboards on your smartphone, all you do is you tap on that icon and it changes. Here I have the standard Apple keyboard. Here I go to my Emoji keyboard. Now I'm over to the Ginger keyboard. And all of these work in a slightly different way. Obviously, the Smiley keyboard gives me dancing penguins, should I want. And the Ginger keyboard is a predictive text keyboard that we've, again, shown you in a different video. But let's go back to the TextExpander Touch keyboard and show you how it works. I'm going to put in a shortcut. Let's say that somebody's asked me how they subscribe to the YouTube channel. This is a keyboard shortcut that I use over and over again. And I can never remember that complicated URL for people to subscribe to this channel. So instead, what I can do here is I use a keyboard shortcut. Now, I use the keyboard shortcut. I use a hashtag or a pound key to start all of my shortcuts, which is something that I'm actually rethinking because it's very convenient to use the pound key on your computer for shortcuts, but I have to navigate in and out of the special features or the special characters menu to do it on this keyboard. So I'm rethinking that. The keyboard shortcut though is pound key YTSUB for subscription. So watch what happens when I type that in. It auto-fills. Do you see that? It auto-filled the information as I typed it in. And that works the exact same as it does on my desktop computer. So whenever I create, so the same snippets that I've created on my desktop carry through onto my mobile device. Now on the desktop computer, I think TextExpander costs $39. Actually, I can just check this. Let's go to the Smile website, and I've got the TextExpander here, and it is, $34.95 is the cost of it for the desktop version. And TextExpander Touch, which we see here, is available for $4.99. As far as I'm concerned, if you use TextExpander on your desktop, it's an indispensable tool on your smartphone. Even if you don't use it on your desktop and you've got a lot of repeating text that you're entering on your smartphone, I think it's a tool that that pays for itself in just moments, especially if you come up with a good strategy of the types of snippets, the type of text that you want to store and expand. Now, having installed this, one change I'm going to make is I'm going to go through all of my snippets over the next little while, and I'm going to change them from the pound key or the hashtag pound key with the name to, I think I'm going to go with the double first letter. So for YouTube subscription, it would be YYTUB. And so that's going to be a unique character string. What you have to do is you have to make sure that you come up with a character string that's not in your normal typing sequence or it'll suddenly expand. So coming up with a nomenclature that works for you is something that's going to be well worthwhile. But as far as I'm concerned, if you live in the Apple universe, TextExpander, a must-have app on your desktop, and now TextExpander Touch, a must-have app on your smartphone. I hope you found today's video to be useful. If you have, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First is you can subscribe to this channel. The second, subscribe to our newsletter. Then you'll hear about all of our upcoming webinars, courses, and other live events. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported by our patrons through the crowdfunding site Patreon. Drop by our Patreon page, have a look. There are perks involved in supporting Dotto Tech. You should have a look. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.